Come on, Mary! Come on, Mary! Come on, I right, show us mine.
Come on, Penny.
Come on, all right, let's go.
Thank you.
Come on, please.
Shot. Okay.
Come on, Tracy. 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 Come on, Tracy.
Wasley. Come on.
Yeah. Come on, Mikey. Come on, I say, come on. bit.
Come on,
Don't worry.
Come on, Paul. Come on.
Don't worry. Let's go, mate.
on the table.
Thank you.
cooking.
Come on, baby. Come out. Good luck.
Val, who is it?
Come on, team.
Come on.
same time.
Come on, Joey.
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 play.
Kane, I love this kick.
Hello guys, this is Gusta Giorgio, the young superstar, number one ranked player in the world in under 21s. Shot the high stats, and joining me is young Mikey Cacciatore,
yeah,
from South Australia.
That's myself, and he got my last name wrong. It's Mike Cacciola, actually.
Yeah, the
Cacciola,
young,
actually, to be
the young superstar from South Australia.
Yeah, go SA.
This is huge. We've got some women's team matches on at the moment. We'll give you some updates from the men's singles.
Yeah, exactly. I was just going to say before we go ahead, you go ahead.
I'll give them the results first. Well, Phil Riley, the computer, aka Goggles, took apart Stevie Wood 7-2.
Yeah.
And big time Benny Noonan just destroyed the machine, Mark Williams 7-0.
Seven donuts,
and looked to be playing pretty well.
Tell you what, that is going to be a cracking match, Gus Giorgio. Ben Noonan versus Phil Riley in the next round.
Oh, is that the next match, is it? Well, that is, I believe, I think the winner out of that.
Do you reckon could go on and win it?
We'll go very close, if not win it, Mikey.
Kelsey, I'd have to agree with you.
But yeah, I still don't understand quite like why they haven't put men's matches on here. But
exactly. No, before I say anything, I don't want to get in trouble. But
yeah, me and Mikey probably got to keep a lid on it. But
yep. Nah.
It's how it is.
What have we got here,
on.
Gus?
Where are we? So it's Vic leading NT 6-2.
Linda Wellerman, I believe, is at the table versus Melanie Sanders?
That is Melanie Sanders.
I hope so, because that's the only girl I know from NT. So.
Did she beat Nicole Walsh last night?
She did.
Really? Well, that is... Well, that's... Yeah.
That is a big result, Gussie DiGiorgio.
That's an upset.
Yeah, I reckon she's just going to chop this in the corner and just come straight back up.
Yeah, natural. Yeah, oh, she's under-hit it there.
Oh, she's under-hit that one.
Oh, she got two shots, Mikey.
She's got two.
But this
I
is
tell
huge.
You, she's not under... She's not on that one. Oh, no, she is. Yeah, I reckon she is.
You've got the plan as well.
Yeah. Just roll this one, one cushion, straight up table for the red in the right hand bottom pocket.
Oh, didn't she?
She's thinking about something. Oh, she didn't have two, ladies and gentlemen. There it is. You got Tracy Scary in the top of the screen there. And looks like it's a scrappy break, and she's on the red balls.
Oh, SA and ACT for all on the other tables.
Yes.
On the other TV tables.
Taylor Meyer versus Cindy Blackmore.
The young gun from South Australia.
Yep. She's definitely an up-and-comer.
Hits a very good ball. Yes, Adam Blooming's just texted through saying, put the men on. I can't say the other word, but sakes. That's the last one. Yes, we've tried Adam, but, mate, we got to move on.
Who said that?
That was young Adam Blooming.
Oh, Ads.
Another one of the rising stars of in 8-ball.
He's a talent and a half, I tell you, Gussie.
Is what I like to call him the machine from Montrose. So anyway,
his
Melanie
also
Sanders,
a beautiful lady.
Yeah, no, he's got a great family. Yeah. His sister's dating Kurt Dunham.
Yeah, one of the best in the sport at the moment.
So here we go, Melanie Sanders on the black here. She's got the big pocket.
I hope that's Melanie Sanders, but yeah.
She's got the big pocket here, Mikey.
It is huge off that red. I reckon she's going to pot it clean, Gus.
Slow rolled it and used
that's
the big
a great shot. That is a great shot by Melanie.
Gets a frame back.
Big win against the skipper of Victoria.
No, it is Linda Element, one of the finest lady pool players going
so
around.
We've just switched over to SA versus ACT. Still this frame with Taylor Meyer and Cindy Blackmore.
I like the way Taylor plays.
She's very composed, isn't she?
She's got a great game. Attacks the game.
Yep.
Pots well.
Doesn't mind a good old safety battle as well.
Carly Norbury.
Oh, it's not Cindy Blackmore.
Just got to put a lid on it, mate.
Got that wrong.
On the best commentator going round.
What's her name?
Oh, Carly Norbury. She's
Why is she typing on the...
That's the chat, Mikey.
Oh. The chat. Okay. You got Lyndall Hulley at the top of the screen there. Yes.
Just being joined by the plum standing behind us. He's
the plum.
He can drink.
He can.
Oh. That's what I left. Salty, that's fucked.
Oh.
Oh. That's off.
Ladies and gentlemen, somebody's just let off a ripper.
That's absolutely filthy, Mikey. That
like they say, Gussie, though, the show must go on.
Now let's get back to the pool here, Mikey. Been sidetracked a little bit. This is big stuff here.
What are you just going to do here, Gussie?
We've got some dead rubbers in the team matches here in the ladies.
Yeah.
Up.
Oh. Here's a chance for Taylor. I reckon she's
I think you'll find Taylor trying her game here.
Yeah, just drop the one over the hole, come up table, and then, I don't know.
Other red in the corner,
the other red in the corner.
Possibly even extract the black out, you reckon?
There's a chance, but I reckon she's just going to drop behind the black and run it down the rail. But what do I know?
Yeah, I don't know if it's on down the rail. It looks... When we look at it bare... It
oh, she's played a smart shot.
Well, that's... She's in control.
Just a one-rail escape. Gussie?
Again, we're sorry to the viewers out there that do want to see the men's singles matches. This is the big stuff right here.
Exactly.
What's going on. Well, Dan Lynch just told us we'll have quarterfinal matches in the men's tomorrow morning.
Yeah.
Then you can hear me and Mikey's lovely voices again.
Exactly. I know you love us, viewers.
Ben Noonan and Phil Riley is going to be an absolute cracker.
Tell you what, that's the one where Maher's going to be focusing. Hopefully that's on the stream tables.
Yeah, I'm sure it will be.
Taylor Maher here, just a little plant to set herself up for the frame.
Just the one shot here, so. What way is she going to go about this, Mikey? Would you?
Gussie, I reckon she's just going to screw up near the yellow and just play it down the rail.
Yeah, that sounds like a good
option. She could play for an extraction or a double, but I just think she's just going to roll it down. Back her ability.
Oh,
and she's gone off the table. Tell you what, that that only happens when the scooping action comes involved. It's underneath the cue ball and then goes up.
Yeah, that's exactly right, Mikey.
A lot of people just like check their tip after it, but I just don't have a bar of it because it's just all about the way you cued it. What did they say? Grari. Who's Grari?
Well, okay. Yes. Grari, you probably would know more than me.
Who's Grari?
Anyway, what's going on over here? So.
Okay, she's had two in. I don't think she can go game. I reckon she's going to double this across, Gus. Yeah, there it is. That is a really good shot, but...
Well,
I'll tell you what, Gus.
Still got two shots?
No.
No, the one shot.
She missed her first ball, and
just
I reckon...
Just shows how much attention I'm paying.
You could even go the aggressive option of doubling the blank.
Yeah, Michael, this is just a straight double, mate.
Tough shot, though. Under the pumps, four all.
And
she has played it amazing. That
absolutely
is a great
nailed
shot.
It.
And the ACT girls go wild.
Here you go. They've got the great Margorski from Victoria, who you met earlier.
She is a beautiful
couple
lady.
Days ago, yes,
top lady. Not only matches her talent, but just a great lady off the table.
Absolute legend of the game. Playing Christina Arcomeno from the
yep.
Territory, who went to England this year.
I'll tell you, Gus, when I went to England in 2012, this lady did co as well, and she goes all right.
She's a great player.
Good talent from NT.
Oh, that's actually Graham Wright. Hello, Gazza. That's Graham Wright.
Not played that too well. Justin, you know Margorski better than me. Is she out here?
Yes, she is.
Play this one to the bottom of the screen.
Unless she doesn't do a Gus and snookers herself.
She won't do a Gus. And Gus would put it out for me.
Oh, I don't know about that, Mikey.
6-2, not much pressure on yourself.
I believe I passed you in the stats now, mate. What happened today? Did you have a bad day, did you?
No, I won one from... Yeah, I did have a bad day, actually. Let's just cut to the chase.
Yeah,
I had a shit day.
It is hard to get up and about for every day in the Mikey.
Oh, it is.
It's both our first national and...
What are you now, Mark?
I think I'm 21 wins out of 35.
Yeah, well, you're two frames in front of me, Gus.
Yeah, but it's a tough gig, isn't it, Mikey?
Well, you're a freak, so I don't...
No, it's...
Margorski here, she's got a little bit more angle than she wanted. I think she's
going
to cannon into the yellow and then leave a long shot at the top left-hand corner.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, the haze
look
quality.
Look at that. How good is that one? She's played an absolute cracker there.
To stop it dead there for the black in the bottom right-hand corner. Oh, she's pulled out the sleeve. No risks.
She's played an absolute cracker. And Mark Gorski over here.
I'll tell you what, guys. That is just huge.
How good was that shot? And there it is.
Well played,
7-3 Victoria.
The legend of the sport, as you would say.
The playing manager, Mark Gorski.
So we've switched over to one of the greats in the game,
yes,
Renato Dalhunty.
Speaking of the great, Renato Dalhunty.
Definitely runs in the family. With James Dalhunty back home. Couldn't make it this year.
And the great
study
McDonough,
and work,
yeah.
Work
yes.
commitments.
Yep.
But he's definitely a talent going. Oh.
Yes, if you're listening out there, Jimmy, hello. We miss you, mate.
I've just been... I just checked my phone, Gus, and You know James George Artis.
Yes, he is one of my favourite guys out there.
I wish he was here, guys.
Oh, he would be buzzing.
Legend That's of for the sure. sport. Or going to be a legend of the sport. So, Bethany Ross.
Gazza, I made the stateside on my own merit, mate. And,
okay. Obviously, the trouble ball here, Gus, is the ball on the left, the red ball near the yellow.
Yeah, in between those what two yellows and the left do, yeah. side rail. Well, bit of extraction, I think, Mikey. If yes. anyone can do it,
it's Renata Delahunty.
If there's anyone that can do it, it is Renata Delahunty.
She has produced a phenomenal pool player as a son, hasn't she?
James Delahunty.
Oh my God, that
yeah,
guy.
Him and the Ross just came back from representing Australia at the World Cup of Pool in Nineball.
They did,
and,
they did.
We probably shouldn't talk about it a bit more, but...
Just feel like that match... Yeah, no, let's just not talk about it. Good shot by Renata. Just so the viewers know, it's not CueballTV's fault that it's not getting streamed
on
1, 2, and 4, and 5.
Bill, if you think it's CueballTV's fault, mate, you're in all sorts.
Exactly, it's not the lad's fault. It's the Australian Able Federation Committee
Able Federation.
Putting these matches on, but I tell you what, these are quality matches, so.
So there, Renata's just promoting her Red Bull, and that's a pretty good shot.
She's basically said, see if you can pot out of me.
Correct.
Bethany Ross, I believe, daughter of Warren Ross.
Yes,
the treasurer.
He should be coming shortly.
He'll be here soon. Definitely a legend of the game.
Yeah, he's...
Even though not ability-wise, but...
yeah,
nah, I love Wazza. He's good lad.
Not the greatest pool player going around, but...
Ooh, Graham Wright doesn't really like you.
Nah, Jazz, look, mate. You
Gussie, she's a chance to sort of open up the game.
I love you, mate.
She's hit that way too hard.
I'm just happy I made the last 64 of the men's singles. I'll settle for that one.
Oh,
it's all about the team, though.
Ben Crawley just sent me a Facebook message. The brother of Travis.
Yes, Jimmy, me and Cody Richardson did beat you and Mike in the doubles, if that's what you want to know.
No, they got lucky, though. So.
Anyway, Bethany Ross over here. She seems to be a good player, Bethany.
Bethany is all right. I remember seeing her at my first junior national titles.
Yeah, she's played a few juniors, junior years.
Ooh. Okay, here's a big chance for Renata Delahunty. I believe she's...
Play the Jackie here, Mikey, on the right-hand side.
Yep, the cannon. I was thinking the exact same thing, Gus Georgia. If you pot it, you drop behind the red near the yellow, or either the pot up the top right-hand corner.
My mum just texted me saying, me and you are a great combination.
Gus, Franca is a legend. I love her. Beautiful. That is
a fantastic shot
by Renata Delahunty. That is massive.
How much angle has she got in this red, though?
She can either just drop it in or even maybe nudge into the little cluster there.
Bit of extraction. Bit risky.
It is risky, Gus. It is risky.
I reckon she just might drop it in and take the long red in the left corner.
Would you maybe even put a little touch of bottom right and come out for the red near the yellow in the bottom left?
That is possibly... I'm sorry, I'm just hearing the VIX, and that's possibly the worst chant.
Yeah, I didn't like that.
I've ever heard.
That's worse than Peri Chicken Sub.
Now, come on, Mikey.
For James Nifted.
That's the greatest song in 8-Ball.
I couldn't hear you. Does he? Well, I don't really get it. Where did that Peri Chicken
I'll explain to you when we're off air, Mikey.
Yeah.
It's probably not G-rated. Yeah, I'm going to stay G-rated here.
Got to get behind Miguel's here. They're 7-4 down. So.
Look, the girls are just happy we're watching it, Mikey. It's... great stuff here.
No, it's an honour on my behalf.
Renata Dell'Arte.
She is a legend.
Made the world final, singles final, which is absolutely huge.
Is Emma Cunningham? Ben Crawley, from my position right here, I cannot see any men results.
Yeah, the men's singles games are happening in a different room.
They're in the back room.
Actually, and there's also men's singles games going on where
right now, Fremantle. Mick Dell'Arte. What?
There's some matches going on in Fremantle as well. Yeah, and also at Subiaco. So that's where we're at.
I'm going to leave you with that one because I'm not sure what you're talking about.
And there's also a men's singles game going across the road at Coles as well. So that's...
took me a while to get that joke, but pretty funny. Anyway, back to the Renata Dell'Arte game. She could probably just roll this in. No, it's pretty long distance. Camera can be deceiving.
That's exactly right. The cameras can be deceiving. But I think we got the best spot in the house,
Would
mate.
You chop it in the middle?
I think it could be worth chopping in the middle, and the white naturally. That's exactly what she's done.
Oh, no, my SA
that's a great shot. I think you've just called the first shot, mate.
What do you mean the first shot?
I think you've just picked the first shot.
You're probably right.
In your commentary career.
I'll tell you what, Gussie, this is probably one of the biggest frames in the match right now. This one and the next one.
It's 7-4 to ACT. I didn't quite...
It's an upset, isn't it?
Well, it would be. ACT's in the four, but SA is, you know, the strong favourites.
For the tournament,
that's a great shot. Just look at their top three: Renata Dell'Arte, Elise Mavitt, and Lyndall Hulley.
After this frame, I need to go give her a quick high five for that.
So here we go. We'll be 7-5
in the hole. There it is. Renata Dell'Arte smiles at her opponent.
Yeah, that's what I find with the women. Every time when they shake hands, they really do give them a nice...
Yeah. Either a smooch or a nice cuddle.
It's either a kiss or a cuddle or a big smile.
I wish I got some cuddles after I lost.
Yeah. Probably the men's place should probably take a note out of their book and...
That is a great shot.
Just a little bit of a kiss here and there.
From the young Northern Territory lady, that is a phenomenal
shot. As we just
said,
we are trying to keep you updated with the men's, but they are in another room. If we could just get someone to... Dan Lynch is going to go check some scores and we'll give them to you as soon as we get them.
We've dropped that hint again for Dan Lynch and he's actually he's jumped on again and he's going to go have a look.
Yeah.
Come on, SA! Woo! Nah, we say more girly than them.
That's another, speaking of chance, I cannot believe SA. Oh.
It's better
with
than
their little
go you Vicks ER.
Grown men saying woo. Is just possibly the worst I've ever heard.
William.
No, Bill, you would never ever get on the mic, mate.
See, that is it. So you got Mickey McPherson versus the young lady from Northern Territory. I'm not too sure her name, but from what I've seen, the last couple of shots have been executed beautifully. James Georgiadis.
Mate, you want to talk about the nine ball doubles? Me and Cody Richardson touched you and Mikey up, mate.
Gus, no one likes the bragger.
Oh, you've... Oh.
But we've accepted the defeat. Okay, Ben Crawley has just informed me that is Lisa from NT playing on table one against Mickey McPherson.
Yes, it is good to see that NT. They turn up every year and have a good crack with the the resources they have and facilities.
I tell you, every year there's always at least one player who improves immaculately.
It's... Just look at it. The men's
lady.
Team. The men's team knocked yous off 13-11. I know you probably don't hear about it again, Mikey, but...
And we also drew against ACT today.
Possibly the biggest upset in history. Oh, there you go. Sonia's just told us that he's 3-1 to Brent over Mick Dell'Arte.
Mick Dell'Arte. Who's up? Brenton 3-1 up against Mick Dell'Arte. Thanks, son.
Oh, and here he is. We've just been joined by Phil Goggles, a.k.a. the computer, Fear Factor Riley.
The future Hall of Famer, Phil Riley.
That was a good win there, mate.
Mate, that is huge.
Yes, Phil Riley and Ben Noonan is going to be an absolute cracker.
I'll tell you what, Gussie, that's where my eyes are going.
And we're
going
to have the best seats in the house, Mikey.
Mm-hmm. Right here on CueballTV.
It's going to be a cracker.
I tell you what, Lisa, that is very stiff.
Oh, it was. Oh, I love both of you, you and Woodsy. And, no, because I know how good you are, Phil. I know exactly how good you are.
Ladies and gentlemen, Phil Riley pulled off one of the biggest blacks in history, I reckon, Gus. He missed
was
the straight
the
black,
with Stevie
and then
Woods, was it?
Yeah, and then Stevie Woods snookered him, and then went off one rail and smacked it in the middle.
But that's what the guy's capable of. He's
computer.
He's won everything in the game. Doesn't even play a ball, and he's won three. Berries.
Non-ball player wins a berry straight away. Three, in fact. Anyway, back to Victoria and Northern Territory. Mickey McPherson is a chance to go 9-3 up here.
Again, men's matches, we will be showing the quarterfinals tomorrow morning. So, I believe at 9 o'clock, I think.
Yeah, so. I reckon you're right. James Georgiadis, no worries, Gus Bus. Big money match when you come down. Doubles.
James, I'm not even a normal player, mate, but I'm more than happy to take you on.
Mm. Anyway, back to the Australian women's April titles.
Nikki McPherson played for Australia this year at the World Titles.
She went there as well?
Yes, yep.
Nice. Here comes Dan Lynch with some men's results. Here he comes. Oh, two more steps and he tells us the result.
So we're just going to give you some score updates here. So Mike, are we taking in turns of reading it?
Yep, you tell your boy.
I'll get my fellow Victorian. Jake is 2-0 up on Stevie Gray. Oh, it's Victorian versus Victorian there.
And Brenton Collier is leading Mick Delahunty 4-1.
And I can't read your handwriting, you Dan. Justin Van Kempen.
Van Diepen.
Van Diepen, 5-3 up on Steve Saxon.
Yeah. Rickshaw, yeah.
Is that Kurt you mean?
No, that's Kurt.
And Kurt Dunham has just started against Rickshaw, who I won the nominated doubles with.
Yeah, the random twos draw.
Yeah, that was great.
That is huge. You're a freak, Gus. You can play with anyone, even though Rickshaw is a great player, but you're a talent. Mickey McPherson has played a nice shot there just to land on the black in the bottom right-hand corner.
So what do you reckon? Do you reckon NT can reel off six
There's
of the spin?
Not a chance, Gussie, that NT are ever going to win this game. No offence to NT out there, but I just don't feel it.
There it is, Graham Wright. Graham Wright, I do know Phil Riley quite well. He destroyed me up in the Australian knot. 9-ball in the quarterfinals, 11-4. So, me and the computer had a great bond.
Yeah. So we've just switched over to ACT and SA. Lyndall Hulley, favourite I'd say for the tournament, is a chance to get a game.
And just being joined by Soldy behind us. He's just wouldn't even get a photo of us earlier on.
No.
Apparently, because the lens weren't the right lens, so. Lyndall Hulley, the $1.04 favourite in the women's draw.
Gussie, she is favourite by a mile.
It's going to be hard to stop. Going for a fifth Australian title.
I reckon she's going to drop this one in the middle, come down for the one down the bottom, in the bottom left-hand corner, then come out for the yellow in the middle.
And then black in the left corner.
Yeah.
Should be ABC, really.
Oh,
she's running that a bit far.
That is not a good shot, Gus. That is not a good shot.
I think she can still play the yellow in the right middle. Just follow through with a bit of right hand. Top right hand.
No, Gus. She's gonna come high.
Nah, I think she's fell short there.
Is she on this, Gussie?
Can't quite tell from this angle. But the white's going to be travelling.
Face cut doubles on her.
Not sure how she's going to dodge those reds up the... She's missed the pot. Now, Teresa Whitten, speaking of another great of the game, Teresa Whitten.
Lovely jelly bean.
Teresa Whitten is a great of the game. She's
been around a while, hasn't she?
Yes, she has. Certainly has. And just a lovely lady.
Beautiful. I heard her talk to you before. I really wanted to say hi, but I was a bit nervous. Being my first nationals, I'm a bit shy of talking to the greats of the game.
Yeah, I've had to introduce you to them. Just got to loosen up a bit, Mikey, you know?
No, it's scary. It's very daunting and not a pleasant experience.
It is. I feel you there.
Anyway.
Yes, Graham, I'm giving you a lot of plugs here, but I think it will be Colby versus Lindell in the final.
They're on opposite sides of the draw, aren't they?
They are on opposite sides, I think, and... Yes, I think it's going to be that.
I might have to say you're right.
I think it's going to be a crack of a final.
Yeah. So you've got Renata Delahunty at the top of the screen there. Could give a chance for SA to go 7-6 or 7-0 or even 8-5 down or 9-5
down. Yeah, does it matter if they happen to drop this game?
For SA?
Yeah, I'm not sure if it matters if they drop this.
Oh, this is a whole match? Nah, I don't reckon... They've only lost one match, I believe, and that was against the Vicks. Then they got him the next round, so I'd say not, but you never know. Things could change with the double chance.
Oh, let's see what Lindell Hulley's got here.
Tell you what, Gussie, this is a Nineball shot, and she has been playing Nineball a fair bit.
How's her cue power?
Yeah, I don't reckon. Oh, you never know, though. I'd be... Podding it in the left-hand pocket with bottom right, but it looks like she's going the other pocket with straight top. Three cushions.
Oh, look at this. Oh,
she misses that red. She's on it.
Oh, no, and she's even snooking herself here.
That is stiff.
It just missed. If it would have missed that red, I should have been fat
on the black. In the perfect shot. But you never know, she has a chance. She's sort of got a free shot at it. She misses it, she loses the free.
Yeah, if she just hits it, I...
Soon find out though, Gus. Tell you what.
Yeah, a bit soft. Probably would have gone harder, but it's still a good shot. She still hit it.
Good shot, Lindell Hulley. Nah, I'm right, thanks.
Nah.
Thanks, Soldy. Soldy just offered me and Gus at a lolly. What's this lovely lady's name again, Gus?
That's Teresa Whitten.
Teresa Whitten.
Definitely knows her way around a pool table.
Gussie, what do you reckon? Black inside those reds in the middle pocket? Off the red in the middle?
Actually... if she hits it right, it will go.
She's known to get these shots.
Even Dan Lynch has given us the nod, so.
Dan Lynch. Love him.
Yes, Hammer. Go Hoops. I will be back next week, mate. I want the red carpet out and everything, so looking forward to it.
This is a big shot for SA Women's. Straight double, well, not straight double, but double into the middle pocket, left hand.
So here we go. Oh no, she hasn't gone for it.
She's hit it way too soft. Oh,
just
what is she?
Setting
she's
it
not
up.
Even going for it. Gus, I'll tell you what, that was a big pocket.
I reckon she's going to go a snooker here. She's going to play that red.
near the left middle, that first red.
Yep.
And just bump it down and keep the white behind that other red.
Yep. That is definitely the shot, Gus. She's looked at it now. She's looked at it now. Yep, she's looked at it.
What? That's the only shot I see.
That has to be the only shot you got to play right now. Push the red to the left hand and just snook it behind the other red. She's overcooked that.
Yeah, she's played it well.
So the black doesn't go on the side.
Strong favourite for this frame. Actually, Mikey, the standard's gone up from yesterday, I believe, mate. It's, it's standard. Oh, so Lidl could see it, and oh, that's still a good leave though, Mikey. She's forced Therese in playing the plant here.
The plant? Renata Delahunty looking to pot out over there. Yellow over the bag. On the black. On the black now, Renata Delahunty.
Oh, look at that.
Gussie.
No, I think that's perfect. That's perfect.
Goes underneath the black, and then she's out.
Certainly does, Mikey.
She has. We've just looked at the proper table. Renata for the black to go 7-6. She has nailed it. Renata Delahunty, 7-6, Australian Capitals Territory.
So Teresa Witten will just mop these up and put ACT 8-6 up.
For an 8-6 lead. These are important balls for the ACT.
So Rhiann Bolton, this is for the win here.
Shot by Teresa.
Yeah, Teresa won't miss these.
A little screw back here, Guffy.
And so there it is. So
what about a huge screw back?
Yeah, she screwed that in the car.
Teresa.
Nah, she's fine.
Bit of exhibition. Rolls it in, beats Lyndall Hulley, the favourite for the tournament. 8-6, ACT, SA.
Switch it to Rhiannon Bolton now. She's cleared these well.
Is this for the win?
Well, it's for the win, and then I'm sure they'd want to carry on for a bit of percentage.
Yeah. And they're bound to get it. Just come up table. One cushion. Black in the bottom left-hand corner.
Oh, she underplayed that.
She's come short. She's still chop it in the middle.
I reckon she'll take the double on.
Is that what you do?
Yes. Because if you look at it with the bare vision, it's thinner than what the cameras show.
Well, whatever she's playing, she's probably going to make it. And she hasn't made it.
Yeah, no, she's missed it. And
here's a chance for
left her opponent on the yellow.
Christina Sarmiento. Big chance.
Don't think Christina's going to mess this up.
She can't. She can't afford to miss it for a state.
Now just going to drop this yellow in.
Yeah.
And Northern Territory could come back on the charge here, Mikey.
That's a great
shot.
She's
played that with a lot of conviction.
Played it with confidence.
Style and finesse.
Conviction. And just screw back and the black in the side. 9-4 Northern Territory down.
Oh no, and
she has
absolutely screwed that
too well.
In the car park.
I didn't get why she had to. She didn't have to screw it back quite that much.
Oh, and she still nailed it.
That is a great shot.
Well.
She's just nailed in the top left-hand corner.
Steve Jameson, who's been best on ground off the table? Oh, look, no one likes a bragger. No one likes a bragger, but I've been not bad on that front either.
So we've just switched over.
Benny Big Time's always up and about.
Yeah, true.
Both.
Elise Mabbott versus the ACT lady. She's played a nice shot there, Gussie. She could take control of this bottom right hand corner. Getting messages left, right, and centre, Gussie.
You're a superstar, Mikey. Absolute superstar.
She's just got to bag this one on the bottom right-hand cushion here. Just bag it over the hole, or in or over, sorry. Yeah, that's the shot. Ooh,
yeah, a bit pacey and hasn't covered. So, at least Mabbott.
Carol Nunn over there on table five. Six, sorry.
Would that be a breaking pot out, or...?
For Carol Nunn.
Break. That'll be the fourth break and clear of the tournament.
For the black in the middle, 8-7. Here we go. Gussie, 2 seconds away from it. It's in there. Go South Australia. I'm a bit of a biased commentator, Gussie.
Yeah.
I don't know.
See, I like to call it down the line, mate.
But if you're, like, when your Vicks are over there, you'd support them like anything, wouldn't you?
Yeah, I would, mate. Yeah.
No, we're true to our states, which is
Vic,
good.
I'm a Vic through and through.
Even though you want to wear a red shirt.
It's actually orange, but...
No.
It is orange, Mikey.
Gus, eyes can be deceiving as well as long as the camera.
So,
Oh, that is a top shot. Gus, what do you reckon? Pop this one up the top near the to the left-hand corner pocket. Two rails for the one near the black, and then drop the one near the yellow.
I think that's what she's doing. She's actually played that really well.
She's played that
even Dan Lynch has gone, oh, that is perfect.
So run through.
That's when you know it is really a perfect shot.
That is a great shot. Run straight through for the red on the bottom right-hand corner underneath the yellow. And she's missed the pot. She has missed the pot, ladies and gentlemen. If you didn't know, she just missed that pot.
Elise Mabbott, I love the way she goes about it.
Tell you what.
Attacks the game.
Gussie, Elise is a beautiful lady on and off the table.
So here we go to Bobby Quinn. Now, we're just going to give Bobby a rap because she has played, is her first national like us. And
yep.
She has played some great pool. And I think she's shooting around 70%, to be honest.
Okay, that is very
good.
High
60s. And
that is huge. That is massive.
Yeah, she's doing great.
Never seen Bobby play.
Oh, I think that's a bit soft.
It's going to roll in there. It's going to roll in there.
It hit?
Umpires, level the table.
Yes, I think it did hit, so... Perfect weight there.
Yeah. Good pace.
Now, Plum's just walked over, but if you're going to let one rip, mate, just...
Yeah.
Yeah.
10-4 Victoria, leading Northern Territory. She's a chance here to just bag this bottom
play the jackie.
Corner. Yep.
In or over?
In or over, yep.
One of my favourite sayings in pool.
The jackie, never heard it.
Oh,
she's played that way too thick.
Yeah, it's... So what way would you go about this, Mikey?
Okay, Gussie, the way I'd go is I'd pot this red in the bottom left-hand corner. I'd cannon into the yellow. I'd try to aim for the yellow. You're a shot at the top two.
She's going to have to manoeuvre the white ball here. There's going to be a bit of...
Well, the white's going natural into the little black and yellow there. and she's gone. She could have gone game there, actually.
So she's, say she's favourite in the frame. Yes, Jamie, the standard has definitely gone up since last night, which is good to see.
Yes, definitely. She's in a lot of trouble here, the young Northern Territory lady. Probably not too bad shot
Bobby here, just get that red out of there.
Yeah, well, you're in total control, why not just get it out of there?
People, just let us know what you think of our commentary.
Yeah, I don't want to upset any of the viewers, guessing.
That's all, Adam. You're
that
in good hands,
shot,
mate.
Bobby. Reminds me of myself, young Bobby. Just an up-and-coming.
Yeah, I think we're actually the three youngest here.
You're
the youngest, I'm the second youngest, and Bobby...
Well, how old are you?
I'm 20.
I'm 19. How old's Bobby?
21.
Okay.
Yeah, so...
Bit of three-way action there, Gussie.
Yeah, as in age.
Yeah. Well, what else are you talking about? Stephen Jameson.
I think Bobby... What's she got here? Like, if it was me, I'd just pot that red in the left corner and try and screw up to the table and pot that.
Well, you pot
red in the
on
up
the table,
to the right, right hand corner. But that's why we're not out there, Mikey. We're not good enough to be at the stage, mate.
It's not that easy for me. Greg Dingle just wants to get on camera.
Yeah, it's the Dingleberry.
Ben Corny, Crawley, I love you. Why aren't you playing for SA this year?
Yeah, I was going to say, hasn't he been in the state team?
No, let me give you a bit of history on young Ben Crawley. The guy has won a junior world title.
Yes, he has, yes. That's correct.
He beat Mark Warry in the final, from South Australia, Australia. Yeah, Ben Crawley is a talent. He's a gun. He's actually switched games, though. He's an American 8-ball player and /9-ball player now. Just recently went to Las Vegas and had a few good results there. Won a tournament over there for a bit of cash. And, yeah, no, he's going all right. Good old Ben Crawley. Love that, Blake.
Yeah, Steve Jameson says he's loving the commentary.
Good commentary, guys. Thanks, Steve Jameson.
Well, it's better than no commentary, I think. And look, no one wanted to put their hands up to do the women's pool.
We've done the good thing in the spirit of the game, like Dan Lynch does every year, every tournament.
Exactly. You know, it's doesn't really. You know, he should get more for it.
Seriously, our game wouldn't be streamed if it wasn't for
exactly
good old
Danny right.
And Kim.
So you people complaining out there, you're lucky. He's even have stream.
Exactly. You tell him, Gus.
Now, if you're Bobby here, he's going to tap that red in the right-hand corner.
Here's a chance here for Bobby. Just tap it over the top right-hand corner.
Just
leave it over
double kiss it.
Yeah.
And you're laughing here. And the Northern Territory lady is going to have to find something.
Just a quick shout-out to Shane and Maddie Bills. Getting married next year. I'm glad to be one of his good mates. He's going well, and he's definitely going to be at these Nationals one... Yeah.
Yes, I've never heard of him actually. What's
Shane
his
Bills, yeah.
Shane Bills.
He's one of my good mates. He's definitely improved over the last couple of years. Anyway, back to the pool.
So I'm not sure what the young lady from NT is going to do here, but
nah, she is in total not control.
Actually, that's a good shot.
Kelsey, I'll tell you.
That is a good shot. It keeps her. Keeps her in the frame a little bit, yeah.
Elise Mabbott just won her frame over there.
Yeah, 9-8 South Australia, so they've
At least
got the comeback.
Freak show. Ben Crawley, we're glad we can add some commentary to the... comedy to the commentary. Okay, Bobby
here. The score
in
the Queensland game is 6-5 WA. Or 8-6, sorry, to
WA.
WA.
Yeah.
So...
Good shot by Bobby. Just a containing safety shot there. Just make sure she's still securing this frame. Still 80-20% in Bobby's favour, this frame. Another ball, Gus. She's just killed another ball.
So I think there's probably another hour and a half left in this frame.
Gus,
there's
you can't.
Oh, Mikey's lost it, ladies and gentlemen. So Bobby's just Yeah, Jordan Mitchell. Yes, we'll give you a mention. Okay, that's Jordan Mitchell. There's your mention, mate.
The legend.
No, another good young player from South Australia.
Up and coming. Okay, we've been a bit sidetracked at Gussie for the women's teams round 12. 10-4 Victoria NT.
Yeah. We probably should switch over the other game, but Dan Lynch has just gone on us. But
can we somehow operate it?
Yes, we will switch back to the SA and ACT game.
Yeah, it's definitely a lot closer. SA frame, yeah. Joey Sullivan.
Because this
almost there, ladies and gentlemen. Raffle's just there in the background.
So here we are. It's South Australia. Yep. On the draw.
Joy Sullivan versus Bethany Ross.
Plenty of experience with Joy Sullivan.
Definitely. Victorian multiple state team member and also South Australian. Ben Crawley knows all the biddies. We love you, Ben Crawley.
So what's Joy on here?
Joy, I believe she is on the yellow
yellows.
Ball.
Just by looking at them, they're favourite.
The plant isn't on, as demonstrated by that shot.
Yeah, a bit pacey.
She's played a sort of containing safety shot there. Bethany's got a lot of work to do here, but... We'll soon see, though. These ladies.
Adam Blooming, we'll say it again, mate. We cannot physically show you men's matches.
Yeah, it's not Dan Lynch's fault.
We cannot physically do it.
We can show you a few of the men's ball players, but they're just off camera. So, Joy Sullivan, I reckon she's just going to roll this over the pocket. Yeah. In or over.
In or over.
Yeah.
And bit pacey.
Like, Gussie, you got to just roll them in.
But it is very easy to get a rush of blood, Mikey.
Yeah.
I know all about it.
Yeah, me too, Gussie. Me too. I had a horrible day today. One win, three losses.
Oh, so Danny's just zooming in on the table here.
Ooh.
Oh, look at this. Look at this for a view, Mikey. An unbelievable view here.
Mate,
this is big.
Dan Lynch just gets better by the second. Not minute, second. His co-worker, Kimpton Crest, is, I reckon he's gone for a bit of a nap.
Yeah, Kim, I'm commentator. Oh, speaking of Kimpton Crest, he's just turned up behind us.
Speaking of Kimpton, he's just behind us.
Commentated earlier with him in the day.
He's a legend, isn't he? We love Kimpton. Double kiss. There it is. Okay, so we've got Bethany Rotti. Very important frame for the ACT girls, just to go 9-all. She's just chucked that in the top right-hand corner.
So, what do you see here, Mikey? It's
Gus, if that red by the black goes in the bottom right-hand corner, she's a chance at going game.
Yeah,
like,
it certainly
a chance
does.
I reckon the key shot is... Oh, she's got a safety option. Oh, did I hit the rail first?
Nah, that was a fair shot. Mikey, that's your bias coming out of you, mate.
Yeah, it is, isn't it? Come on, Joy, fire up.
No one likes the bias commentator.
No, we all go for someone. We all go for someone, Gussie. So, yeah. What Joy Sullivan
just
is
a quick it? Update on the other table. Like I said, there is... That frame is still going. Oh, you're right, Mikey.
What?
Just switching back, it was a foul.
It was a foul, two shots.
You were right.
I tell you, the bias doesn't come out of me. I'm a fair player.
That's a good call. You've just called the second right call since you've started
second?
Your commentary career.
Okay. I'm happy with that. Happy with that. Okay, she's just going to roll this down the bottom left-hand corner. Yes, Chris Ormsey, I do need a Jaeger.
So that's a big...
That is a
Joy
fantastic
Sullivan.
Shot from Joy
Great
Sullivan.
Plot.
Go SA. I mean, nah, nobody likes a bias.
It's a great pot.
Still with two, Gus. She's game. She's gone out here. She's out and about here. Love the zoom in view. Perfect for the viewers at home to see. Yep, just a little skim off the other yellow, perfect angle.
So
go to the right-hand side of the table.
She's definitely going to go the out here.
Gussie, I reckon she's just going to pop this one to the bottom right-hand corner. Go over to the two on the right-hand side there as well. Clear them up, and then the two on the left-hand side, game over. Oh, and she's missed that. There's another twist and turn.
She does have a second visit.
Do you still go out here, Gussie?
Oh, personally, I would, but that's... Everyone's different, Mikey.
Shut, Joy. Still a chance here, Gus. You can either play a nice snooker here, just roll up to this one near the bottom right-hand corner, behind the other yellow, or she could even maybe chop this in.
Yeah, can she cut it in, Mikey?
I can't really see. The camera is just... I don't know.
It's a fantastic angle.
I think too much angle, yeah.
Yeah, I think she's tapping up to it.
Yeah, no, that's perfect. Leave her on the one near the eight.
This has forced her to take... Unless you can see the other red just past the middle pocket. Yeah, it's a shot by Bethany. But I think Joy's going to try and go to the out here.
Yeah, she's going game.
Surely.
If she's not on this one to the left, she's going to take the plant and just pot out.
To the left.
Gussie, I'm telling you, she is out. She is clearing this table like no tomorrow.
Yeah, this is over here, I think.
Touch a right hand, left hand side, sorry. Come above the yellow. Choice at the middle of the yellow. Just a little touch left. Oh, she is gone.
Oh,
that is.
Look at that.
Gussie, what would you do here? Roll the one to the middle?
Oh, I'd actually go the corner one.
I'd pot the yellow in the right hand corner, two rails, pop out fine in the middle, black in the
where right the yellow's about to go now.
Correct.
Yeah. Okay, I've just had a score update. Mick Delahunty is 6-2 up against Brenton Collier.
Mick Delahunty is 6-2 up.
That's what Aaron Lynch, unless he's telling me Paul.
How can he be 6-2 up if it was 3-1 Brenton?
Yeah, I reckon Aaron Lynch is telling me porcupines.
Yeah, I think Aaron's had a couple.
Yep. Gussie, she's gone your way and my way. My third call of the day. Just stop it right there where the yellow is for the black in the bottom right hand corner.
And there you are.
Joey Sullivan, turn back the clock. Let's go, SA. 10-8, sorry. Do you remember?
And there it is, South Australia.
South Australia have just won that match from nowhere.
They were. That's a good comeback.
That is a
good
fantastic
comeback against the top
comeback.
Four side.
The ladies are cheering like.
So now they'll go SA woo.
SA woo. So Gus, do you know Shane Bills?
I probably did by face. I'm not very good with names though. We've just been told we're going to have Dax Wasley versus Sean Partridge. For all you Victorian viewers, that will be on.
That is going to be
on
a
next.
Cracking.
Now that is a battle of heavyweights.
At it.
We can't wait, Mikey. I'm excited. Are you?
God, I cannot wait.
We have finally.
This is going to be a. This is going to be a match and a half.
This is going to be big.
Dax Wasley versus Sean Partridge. That is going to be a match and a half, ladies and gentlemen.
So for all you Victorian viewers, Sean Partridge will be playing on the TV table.
Gussie, my tip here is the Wonder Dax.
You tip Dax. Well, look, Dax did beat Justin Sage, but Sean Partridge, he's done some massive outs this week.
He's a freak. What about his little incident today?
Oh. Yes, well, we'll mention Sean Partridge. He did... He did snap a chair.
ladies and gentlemen, Sean Partridge did just have an incident with a chair that was playing up all 2 weeks, actually. But it finally gave way. And the big boy from Victoria just... yeah. Shawnee! Here he is. The man is Shawnee! Oh, he's focused, I reckon. He's got, yeah, no worries. Mickey McPherson here, 11-5 up. She's a chance of getting in control. She's in control, in fact, with the yellow down the bottom left-hand corner. Gus has just informed Sean Partridge that there's about 120 people watching this.
I did just inform the pasty, known as the Pear Tree Partridge, that there are 120 people watching and there's no pressure. So
I tell you, this is going to be a match.
I can't wait, Mikey. I'm that excited.
It's going to be that aggressive. I'm not even going to be aggressive ever.
We've kind of forgot about the women's team here. We'll just finish off the women's team. I know it's hard to hold our excitement, but...
I'm excited, Gus.
Melanie Sanders, one of our favourites.
Oh, yeah.
She's...
Race 7.
So,
Melanie Sanders is definitely a legend. She beat Nicole Welsh.
Yeah,
one
I'm
of
sure,
the biggest upsets
yeah.
in the tournament.
Not sure if she's a legend, though.
Oh,
nothing,
not a legend,
nothing
sorry.
Against, absolutely nothing against her.
Yeah. Well, she's going to be a legend.
She,
putting
yeah.
it out there.
It's...
Probably a big call. Probably the wrong call.
It's a large call.
No, there's a chance. You can't predict the future.
So she played deliberate foul.
Just just a shot to get her back in the frame. This is a tough out with two. I don't think she can go out of here unless she plays a great shot here in the side and then somehow develops those ones near the black. But yeah, it's a tough shot. Just played a containing shot there.
I just can't hold my excitement in my head.
Oh, Gussie, I'll tell you what. This 5-minute practice on both players' behalf is going to be the longest.
It's going to be a ring-a-ding. They are seriously the heavyweights, though, aren't they?
Oh, my God. They are.
And no, I don't mean, you know, like their body mass. They're just, they're both all-out attacking players.
Correct, yeah. Gussie, I'll tell you, Dex, his lead-up to this... Yeah, we'll talk about the Dax and Sean match.
That's right. As soon as the Dax and Sean match does start, we will switch it over. Yeah. At the moment, they're just doing their practice.
Yeah.
But we will switch straight over to it.
I can't help but just stand over this computer and look at them pump balls in. I'm excited. Anyways, Melanie Sanders. Tell you what, she is going game here. What do you reckon, guys?
The way she's performed this week, mate, she's a chance.
Ben Crawley.
It's going to be an absolute cracker. Sean Partridge versus Dax Wasley. Unbelievable. Look at the size of Dax's shirt, Mikey. That is...
I reckon I want to swap shirts with
him. I think both of them are... What are they? Is it 4 X's and an L?
No, Gus, I'm not going to...
Large shirts, mate. Anyway.
Tell you what, I wanted to swap shirts with Dax or Rusty.
Yeah, he'd probably be a blanket.
Actually, I want Rusty's because I don't have a New South Wales shirt. So. Okay, Ben Crawley, where's he at? Let's get his conversation up. How much practice do Dax and Sean get?
Oh, I can't wait, Mikey. So, hopefully Sean and Dax don't finish before this women's teams is still going. Just going to pop this red in the corner. So I do have Sean Partridge next to me. Shawnee, how do you think you're going to go, mate?
Fingers crossed I do all right, Gus.
He said, fingers crossed, I hope I do all right, Gus. And a bit of pre-match nerves, mate?
A little, mate, but it's always
helpful. He's ready to go, ladies and gentlemen. It's going to be an absolute cracker.
I'm back, lads.
So I think we're going to get the match underway.
Gus, can I tell you how excited I am for this match?
Oh, it's going to be good.
Melanie Sanders.
How's she doing in the stats, by the way, Mikey?
I don't know.
Yeah.
But I'll tell you what, by just looking at her gameplay, I reckon she's doing fair dinkum and pretty good. Melanie Sanders, I reckon she's just got to be safe and just drop this one to the bottom left-hand corner. If she's not on
that.
Can
she see that red in the, corner? Oh, no, she's got
just,
this red.
Yeah, just drop this in. She's just going to pop this one to the top left-hand of the pocket. Come around one.
Just, would you just hit it? Just hit it.
Thin?
Thin.
Really thin.
And
really thin. Aim for position to hit
possibly
the yellow.
Possibly even play with a bit of left-hand side, I reckon.
Yep. That's a shot there. Oh.
Oh, she's on it.
Okay, she's a chance.
That'll do.
She's on it. She's on it, ladies and gentlemen. Bottom left-hand corner. She is on this ball. Big shot just to keep the girls from NT alive. Well, not alive, but in the tournament. Is that your magic? I've just been called One Direction, Gus.
From who?
From Sean Patrick's missus. I don't really like that call.
Oh, look at that. Melanie Sanders. One of our favourites. Just did not let us down, Mikey.
Linda Hulley, I reckon... There she is. She's a chance there, Melanie Sanders, to beat Linda. Almost about to start, ladies and gentlemen. That's Wasley versus
So we're
Sean
nearly
Partridge.
Ready for the battle of the heavyweights. It's going to be an absolute cracker.
It's going to be one of the best matches in the tournament.
Here we go. I think they're about to lag off. So if we just... Now, do you reckon they can fit when they do the lag or what, Mikey?
Okay, here we go, Gus. We've switched over.
Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Sean Partridge versus Dax Wasley in the last 16 of the Australian 8-ball titles.
Race to 7 and Sean Partridge.
Look at Sean's lag. Tight on the rail.
Okay. Sean Partridge to break. Frame 1.
Who do you fancy here, Mikey?
Oh, I reckon Dax. Shawnee. Gusson.
But yeah, it won't take long for the home crowd to surround this match.
After what I've seen of Sean Partridge, you cannot ride him out, though.
He's done some massive outs in the
freak, man.
In the teams. Just some
he's
huge outs.
He just doesn't care a lot. He just goes out there and gives it all he's got and just plays his heart out.
Oh, just a shout out quickly. I wonder if the egg Brett Rogers is listening to this. He's good mates with Sean Partridge. So Brett, you're an egg, mate. Alrighty, I'm excited.
Can't wait for them to just split these balls. And they've done an incorrect rack straight away. The reds are meant to be at the front.
Not sure what you...
That is true. The Georgie.
I think they're just waiting for an umpire, actually. This is... I think Jingle just said, I'm going to do a few frames. Oh, no. Evan Briggs is going to be the umpire. Now, the WA team manager.
There is suspense on this match, I can tell it. But as soon as they break the balls, there's going to be all guns blazing.
So here we go. Sean Partridge to break.
Yeah.
Race to 7.
First
now, look at this break, Mikey. Watch this break. He's had it down pat all week.
Dry. He's come up dry, come on, Gus.
What do you like?
I like... If he's on a red, I'd like reds. But, yeah, he's on a red. To the left-hand middle.
Yeah, I like reds straight away.
Reds. No doubt about it, Gus.
Nice, easy starter.
Push through this one a little bit, yep.
Yeah, look at these for a first rack.
Pop this one near the yellow.
Sitting very nice.
Leave the white where the red... He's about to pot his pop the other red near the black.
Get rid of these two reds near the black.
Yep. And then game over. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Be prepared for some amazing pull. Dax Wasley has definitely had a great like road to where he is right now. He's beaten the likes of David Rothel.
He did beat Rothel in the first round, yep.
From South Australia, and he's also beaten one of the local favourites, Justin Sage.
Justin Sage, just the name says it all. Not only has he got a great physique, but he's also very good at pool.
If only I have his physique and pool playing skills, I'd be the complete player.
Dax just going through these.
Practice balls here. Look.
Oh, hang on, he's lost the white there. That's a terrible shot.
Yeah, that's a bad shot. He had too much angle on that one in the middle. But anyway, move on.
I think that was just probably a bit of nerves.
Early butterflies. Oh. Okay, here's a chance for Sean Partridge.
Sean, he steps in.
Chop this one to the top hand, right-hand corner. Come over the other side of the three yellows there.
All in the same pocket?
Yeah. Just get yourself over there. Give yourself an opportunity to sort of remove them three and then go game.
Oh, wow, he's potted the red. That is
pretty stiff, I reckon.
That's a little bit stiff.
He's played it with confidence, top left. He is an easy two rail. Straight above that yellow, yeah.
Can't believe he's potted that red, Mikey.
Yeah, that's stiff. The Wonder Dax.
So just listening to the roar for the first frame of the Dax man.
And only one fan goes wild.
As I said, I'm sure the crowd is going to...
they're going to build in if they know it's on. One thing I've learnt this week is we need louder microphones. How about that cow cutter?
So 1-0 Dax Wasley.
Yeah.
Both of them have a lot of firepower, Mikey. Oh. Don't they?
It's ridiculous, guys. They're both...
I just hope the chair Sean's sitting on doesn't collapse.
Let's
like
hope those four legs don't, you know, collapse like earlier on today. I was worried today when that happened. I seen him fall down, we didn't know what was going on.
And, you know, next minute we've saw him on the ground. Like, made the loudest stump of all time.
Waving legs and arms.
So here we go. Look at Dax's break here. Speaking of. Breaks. These two are two of the biggest in the game. He's going straight in off here, so...
Here's a chance here for Shawnee to just get back on this scoreboard.
Exactly right. Kimo just mentioned, in Victoria, if we pot the white in the middle, you're an instant spastic. Ben Noonan is the serial offender of that.
Just a quick shout-out to Amelia and Sarah. They've just complimented me on my commentary.
Yes, thank you, ladies. It's good to see that people are loving our commentary.
Yeah. Go, Amelia.
So I think yellow's here straight away.
Yeah. Do you reckon that yellow near the red on the left there goes? 80 seconds. To the bottom left-hand corner,
yeah, well, it looks like from our view it does, but definitely tight.
Looks like he's going red.
So, no, I think he's going yellow.
Really? Oh, yeah, he's dragging this one in. Oh, yes. The camera's deceiving. He's breaking into it.
Yeah, he's trying to break into it. And he's just killed it even more.
Yeah. It's dead. Sean Partridge from Victoria.
He's a very good killer, Sean. Very good snooker player as well.
Yeah.
Knocked in many centuries.
Yeah. Really? Nice. Hits the ball well.
Like most of us in the Victorian side, most of us do play snooker.
Yeah. There's a lot of normal players in the
He's a bit nervous early, which is very understandable. Oh, very understandable to be nervous.
It's a big occasion, Gus.
Now, do those two reds plant?
No. He could just roll
bit of coverage.
One. Yeah. Just bag the bottom red there of the plant. And, yeah. Yep. Just like we said.
Yeah, that's fine. I think Sean's going to double this back, though, Mikey.
I love this level double, of pull, Gus.
Double this yellow back in the corner.
Ben Crawley's just sent me a message, and the first two words I read was rugby union and completely switched off. Yeah, there's nerves there, definitely, Gus.
Definitely some nerves early on. Yes, hello to my two sisters, Karen and Isabella. I do miss yous.
I miss yous too.
Now, Dax Wasley at table.
Yeah.
Looking to...
For a 2-0 lead.
For a 2-0 lead.
Definitely.
Any sort of lead early would, you know, he's always great. I think round the angle is a break up.
Can you extract those balls now?
I think that's what he's going to try and do. No, he's... Oh, you can do it now.
Yeah, here's another opportunity.
Have a second bite of the cherry.
And of course, he does not hesitate even one bit.
He just goes for it.
Mate, the guy's a fucking mental case. Oh, that... That is
just... This might be perfect if he can... I think he's going to play the plant.
Yeah, double kisses it in. That red... Definitely goes past in the bottom left-hand corner there. So here's a chance for Dax Wasley to go 2-0 up.
Still very tricky though here.
Yeah.
The white's going to be running.
You'd back him though.
Yeah, he's played that really well.
That is such a good shot.
Look at this.
Oh my God.
Now if he's on this red, near these two yellows in the middle of the table, it will be a 2-0 lead.
Yeah. I'll tell you what, Gus, that was a phenomenal shot.
Yeah, Dax looks like he's on early.
Tell you what. My hat goes off to the young man.
One of the funniest guys I know, Dax Wasley.
Hell yeah. Looking like a 2-0 victory here, lead here, sorry, for Sean Pat, Dax Wesley.
He's missed it by an absolute mile, and you know why? He was down on the shot and then jumped off, but stayed down.
He rushed it, didn't he?
Definitely is a lot of nerves here early on.
And he jabbed at it, like, you just...
He didn't even threaten the pocket, Mikey. Did not even threaten.
I'll tell you what, Gus, this is a massive chance for Sean Partridge.
Unlike Dax. Sean is going to try and get a snooker here, but that's not the
huge
greatest...
chance.
He's going to tap this yellow on the left-hand rail and try and get the snooker. Still going to be very careful, though, here.
Chance he could leave it on.
Oh, I think
I don't know if that's on. I reckon that is.
Might be on here.
He's on. He's gone straight down.
I think he's swerving.
I think he's swerving.
No, oh, it goes straight in. So that was a lazy... Fair to say, that was a lazy shot by Sean. He... Really had to make sure that he got the snooker there.
You're not going to get Dax missing those blacks like that very often. And when rare occasions like that happen, you just got to take opportunities. Still, it's only 2-0. It's Shawnee gets one back here. His confidence is back.
So 2-0, Dax Wasley.
Yeah. Don't mind a bit of a yawn, do you, Gus? I'm getting question marks. I don't like the Aussies
and that's
the
it.
English call.
Justin Van Dypen has defeated Steve Saxon. Steve Saxon knocked me out in the second round pretty convincingly, so there you have it. Justin Van Dypen, I believe he's made a last eight at the World Titles. Was a long time ago, but...
Has he?
Yes, he has.
Not going to lie, I beat him twice this week.
I've beaten Rusty Wheeler twice and Brett and Collius. Now I can retire. Now Sean potted a ball there.
No, he's gone dry again. Well, reds are your only chance here.
Well, we can't. Yeah, you can't see a yellow, Mikey, so I think you're right there.
Third right call.
But just by looking at it, I think yellows are slightly better. But
oh, they are, but
so I've seen the pattern here early, but
unless you can call total now, you can't really go for yellows, can you?
Oh, this is dank.
Dax can go game from anywhere they go.
He's just stretching there. Oh, he's played that well.
Landed on
that.
Yeah, he's landed on that bottom one. Perfect.
Still plenty of work to do in this frame, though.
Definitely. Just stun across for the red near the yellow in the left-hand middle.
Which one?
Let's see the red to the bottom of the table there. Right near the yellow. Just stun this ball to the on the rail here, right over for the red in the middle. Left-hand middle.
Oh, yep, yep. And yes, these two styles are pretty much the same, aren't they? Oh my God, Dax has just played another safety.
He's just played a safety. What?
Is he feeling okay, Mikey? Or
I think he's feeling like he wants to win an Australian title.
The man's never played a safety in his life.
Thanks, Amelia. We love you.
What Shawnee got here? Don't think he's really got a pot on here. I think. Oh, what's he doing here? He's going to pot the red here.
Six all with Brenton and Mick.
Just a score update. Six all with Brenton Collier and Mick Dallanti. So we're going to a hill there. That is massive.
It's huge.
Mick Dallanti just does it time and time again. So Sean's given Dax two shots here. Not sure if it was the right shot, but he's saying, Dax, it's all on you, mate. If you go out, good on you.
Yep. And I reckon he's going to go out.
And that's a good shot by Dax.
He's
promoting his reds.
Oh, screw back stun shot here. Yep, there it is.
Yeah, that's perfect.
That is actually plumb. Roll this one in for the red up the top right-hand corner.
Stand across.
Yep. For the one in the left. Another roll in.
That's just ABC, really, isn't it? For these guys, it's ABC.
Oh.
This is the big time now.
The roll in here, I think. Hold your nerve.
Yes, out of the two players, Dax has definitely settled better than Sean has here.
Yeah.
Come on, Dax!
Black in the top right. Here comes Dax's fan base.
Just a screw in the middle of the table, and he'll take the black in the... Yeah.
Top right.
So this is going to be a 3-0 lead.
Oh, there's a rowdy member in the crowd.
He's that Jason Harrett fellow. He certainly loves to...
First Nationals gets a little bit excited.
It's one of the more weird units going around, I would have thought. Oh my God, Dax has missed another black.
He's just done it again.
Unbelievable.
He's just done it again, Gus.
Can you believe it, Mikey? And just looking at Dax's eyes, he just had a smile to us. That's how come.
Dax is
he's just having a laugh with us, and I don't think he can believe it either. You just see the man's eyes.
Tell you what, that black that he just missed will not faze him one bit. He's one of those players that just erases it out of the memory, isn't he?
Dax Wasley?
Yeah,
he's a very funny guy.
He's a gun. He's laughing about it. If that was me, I'd be bloody necking myself.
Oh, I would be putrid. Now, Sean.
Sean has played a smart shot. Now, such an important frame
what
for
do
Sean
you reckon?
Partridge.
Black in the right-hand middle.
Yep. Bottom rail, one rail escape.
Dax loves these.
Still rolling this.
I will not be surprised one bit if this goes straight in and the crowd will erupt here. And look, oh, he's had a crack. Now, Sean's got to take his opportunities when he gets them.
Gussie, you got to get land on these balls near the right-hand side of you and snooker. Or break it out.
Jeez, I wouldn't have gone that way, but he's landed okay.
Here. Me, personally, I need two shirts to put out of you.
I would probably lay a snooker.
Yeah. Just even bounce the bottom one to the little two there. And snooker behind the other yellow. Pressure's on, he's just got to compose himself.
2-1 to 3-0, that's a bit of a buffer.
Yeah.
So.
I'm not too sure what he's doing.
I think he's going to send the white to the... Oh, that's...
That's a good shot.
Good shot. He's got Partridge. So just promoting a yellow and getting a snooker at the same time.
You're giving Dax Wasley another chance.
Is he just going to roll up to it, Mikey?
No, he's going to fucking go for the plot.
Oh, look at this.
No way. Oh, no look at way, that. Dax Wasley.
Dax, man, the crowd has erupted. I told you, Dax loves those ones. He got close with the first one.
He's missed
I still
two.
Believe... I still believe Sean played the wrong shot there. He should have got a tight snooker with those two yellows on the side rail. He had to get hard up. Because Dax Wasley, I told you, he loves those kind of ones. He loves them.
He needed to get him hard up right behind those two.
And I reckon anyway. That's might have railed. That's might have...
he's just said sorry. Dax has just said sorry.
Oh, he said sorry, so he probably didn't even mean it. But that's all he had.
Mate.
So it's 3-0 and Dax the break and it's looking ominous early days for Sean Partridge.
Tell you what, Sean Partridge has the game though, but if he could just turn it around. Oh, Jason Harrop, the loudmouth of the tournament.
He's possibly the most weird unit I've ever met.
He definitely
I wish we could put the camera on him because
he definitely deserves to be on TV. Comedy channel.
Dax's break here and he's come up dry. So this is what Sean needs.
Sean needs an opportunity here where he's just gonna clear up. And go 3-1. Got a bit of work here though.
He has got this yellow to the right middle though.
Yeah, he does.
Oh, this looking at the cameras that we've got, I don't think that yellow pot's in the left middle up the top, but I'd play this yellow to the right middle.
Yep.
And that's what he's doing.
Yeah, he is. You know your Vicks. Jason Harrop is laughing at his shots. I don't really like that.
So he's gonna make the most of this opportunity, Sean.
It's definitely a chance here. What do you reckon, Gussie, I see shot here, the yellow where he's lined up now, off the cushion, off the yellow, in.
Yes. Oh, no.
Oh, he's played it way too hard.
Oh, but look at this, he's fluked it.
He's fluked it.
See, big fluke there.
He's got it, he has to take advantage of this fluke.
It's worked out pretty rosy here.
Stun right across for the one on the left there. Shot, Sean.
Ooh, no, that's okay, I think.
That's pretty good, yeah.
Yeah, that's okay.
Stun right over for the one on the right-hand rail there. Or close to the right-hand rail. Got to cue this well, though. Could spit out top pockets. Yeah, good shot, Sean Partridge.
Yeah, nice shot. That is a fantastic shot. It's a lovely positional shot there.
See, I reckon just drop this one in the bottom right hand corner. You're on the other yellow.
He's pumped that in and is he on that yellow to the right?
Oh, I tell you what, he's got this yellow to the right hand corner here.
Oh, he has
right
two, yep. But where's the cue ball going? Mikey, where's the cue ball going?
I've just done it right over. Right over. Above the black.
So in between the black and that red.
Yeah. Right over. Oh no, he's gone. He's gone.
Yeah, it's really a great shot.
That is phenomenal.
It's a great
shot.
Positional shot.
Sean Partridge. Drop it in the right hand side of him. Put the black in the left hand middle. 4-3-1. Lead to that to Dax.
Yeah, shot Sean.
Are you being biased, guys?
He will take this up to the left corner.
Yeah, we'll pump it in.
Yeah, he's got it. Nice out by Sean.
3-1. Dax Wasley leading Sean Partridge.
So, I've got to say, there's been a couple bad misses, but it's been a pretty good match to watch so far.
It's definitely...
because these two won't hold back. These two will not hold back. They will go all guns blazing.
Oh. They don't give two rats, Gussie. Dax Wesley just
Dax is just telling us how far he missed that black by, and he did miss it by about 4k. He even said himself he had a bit of a shake, so that's how this pressure pull out here. This is the big time.
It's good though, you can laugh about it and just move on.
Oh, Dax, I don't think he ever takes anything seriously.
To heart, Nat.
He's the biggest, softest teddy bear I know.
He's a legend. There's a huge break. And he's
made a yellow.
Yeah.
So straight off the bat, I don't know, I'm liking reds.
I'm liking reds as well, guys.
Yeah.
The umpire's having a moment with the stopwatch there.
Yeah, the stopwatches have been playing up this week.
Yeah. The room is definitely quiet here at the King's Perth Hotel.
Yeah, I've got to say, I expected more WA shenanigans here.
Hmm. Where's the family and the support crew?
He's going yellows.
Tells you. Kick the other red.
Done another fluke here. So it's flukes galore here at the King's Hotel Arena.
Sean Partridge is putting on an exhibition here with flukes. Bit of background noise there, Gussie.
Yep, and I think the match with Brenton and Mick Delaney is over. I reckon Brenton might have just got it.
Did Brenton win?
Kurt Dunham from Victoria. Yeah, Kurt defeated Ricky Shaw from Queensland 7-2, so... yeah, Sean's played a good shot there, Mikey. Back to this game.
Is. Yeah, Dax is definitely in a little bit of trouble here.
So believe it or not, we're seeing a tactical frame with these two. Unbelievable stuff.
I definitely wouldn't have... that probably would have been 100-1 on Sportsbet. Shot there from Dax.
Oh, and we've got a stopwatch going absolutely off its... and we've just got through. Mick Delahunty defeated Brenton Collier 7-6. That is Mick Delahunty.
I won that at $25 for that.
That is unbelievable stuff. I'll just repeat it. Mick Delahunty has defeated Brenton Collier. We've just been told Mick Delahunty was 6-2 down.
And has won 7-6.
Wow. It's all happening. That is unbelievable stuff, Mikey.
It is all happening here at the Australian Able Federation. I'll play for it, Knackers.
Mikey, just express your excitement about that. Oh, but hang on, they're both your teammates.
Exactly, so I can't really express any excitement. One's my captain, so if I bag him, then yes. I'm not going to get a game.
Yeah, it was just those two singles matches that were on. So we'll just repeat it. Kurt beat Ricky Shaw.
7-2.
Jake McCartney, I believe, beat Steve Gray.
Correct, yep.
And Mick Dullahunty defeated Brenton Collier.
7-6, yep.
Ben Noonan defeated Mark Williams.
7-0.
And Phil Riley defeated Steve Woods 7-2.
And also Justin Van Dypen has beaten Steve
Justin
Saxon.
Van Kempen.
Dypen.
Dypen defeated Steve Saxon.
Yep.
So there you are, people.
That's your last 16 matches.
Back to Dax and Sean. We're just so shocked that we've seen a safety frame here. It's
Didn't back like picture that one happening. Yes.
So Dax has played a pretty good shot there, but the black... Oh, hang on. The black does pass, I believe.
It does, Gus. Sean Partridge is another big opportunity.
So I'm going to say straight away, this is 3-2.
You're saying it already?
The black definitely does pass.
Yeah. Yeah, I'd agree with you. 3-2. Thanks, Wasley. Pop this one to the top left-hand corner, come out to the one in the middle.
Oh, he's overcut it. It's actually a bad miss.
Yeah.
I think that's quite careless by Sean.
He's not
so now Dax is really going to cover up this black, I feel. Look at this. He's played that well.
That is great shot.
Oh, but hang on, Sean's got a chance here. Sean can pot this yellow in the left, up the top left corner. Get some angle with that yellow in the right middle.
And drop underneath it.
Drop underneath it for the black in the left.
In the left hand corner.
Bottom left corner.
He's giving him two.
Oh, what's he doing here?
Oh, he stopped.
I'm not sure why he would do this shot.
You got to stop there.
No. I think you got to have a go.
You got to have a dip.
No, he's... That is Sean's normal game, is have a go at it. Just being joined by the Roth behind us. Feel the Roth.
The Roth.
And he's played the delivery foul. I don't like that shot. Dax is just going to simply kick his two reds out of the way.
Too bad, that one.
The Ross just going, what? No, I don't like it, Mikey. Oh. You should just had a crack. Look, that's all Dax needed to do. That's all he needed to do.
Why would you... Well, I don't get that why he'd do that to Dax. Well. No, not...
That Dax is going to clean up here, I feel.
Well, I wouldn't give that.
Really not, did not like that shot by Sean. Thanks, Ross. Oh, he's overscrewed that, though.
No, he's perfect angle. Just drop underneath the red in the top right-hand corner.
Oh, that's right. Barry Kitchener, and he was playing Dean Welsh. That was Barry Kitchener. I'm guessing Barry Kitchener.
You can't assume, though, Gus.
I know, but Bazzy's been on fire. Leading the team stats, I think.
That is plum there from Dax.
So this is... Yeah. So this is it. 4-1. Dax Wasley. I still don't know why Sean played that shot. The out was there.
Yeah.
It was...
Yeah.
And even if he would have missed that black,
yeah,
even if it covered the hole, he's still in control.
Correct.
So it's 4-1 Dax.
So definitely the pressure's on Sean Partridge here. Dax is leading 4-1. Three more to book himself a spot.
Three more frames and
eight.
He's got himself a last eight berth. And I'll tell you what, he's going to be dangerous.
Dax Wasley.
We've said about his run so far. He's had a tough run.
Jason Harrop, the comedian act. He's definitely giving Wasley a bit of a talk.
He's a goose, isn't he, Jason Harrop?
Dax is just calming him down.
I think Dax has said, look, mate, just settle down.
Tell him to
look
sit down, watch me
he
play.
He has too. He's told him to settle down.
He's basically said, Gus, sit down, Jason, and watch me pot out. Oh, he is definitely awkward. Big call by Dax.
Have a look at him. He's got no idea what the score is. So Dax to break. Thank leading you. 4 frames to 1.
Are you ready for an earthquake?
Just look at the size of his hands. Have you seen his hands and feet? The biggest hands and feet I've ever seen.
He's huge.
Look at that.
Look at that.
Oh,
explosion.
The white's flying everywhere. And look at this.
Look at that explosion.
Well, this is huge.
5-1.
Have a look at this.
Gus, I'm calling it now 5-1.
I actually like yellows, but reds are definitely. He's got to go reds.
Reds plum.
They, well, any ball in the rail on these tables.
It's just stuff he would just drop. Oh. Gus, I'm telling you, it is 5-1.
Shouldn't assume anything, Mikey.
Yeah, just like the assumption Partridge goes 4-2. But no.
Yeah, well, he's played that fairly well.
Yeah.
He's going to be running into. Oh, he's just going to clip off this yellow.
Yep.
Oh, no, he could avoid it. Oh, hang on. Where's the cue ball? Where's the. Oh, he's. Ooh, centimetre perfect. I'd actually follow it through.
Oh, yeah, he loves you. Yeah, it was like a stun, wasn't it? Chop on the red near the right hand corner.
Oh, hang on. This is a bit awkward,
top
though.
Top left. Top right, sorry.
This is a bit awkward. If he needs a rest here, this any shot with a rest.
He's lean over, I reckon.
Lean over.
Yeah. No, he's listening to you.
Oh,
no.
Oh, Jesus. This is
he's
dangerous.
Using his,
look at this. Oh.
He's using his athletic ability.
Oh, but hang on.
That is a tough
if
shot,
it goes,
actually.
Is it, does it pass the yellow in the left corner?
Just, I reckon, from the Roth.
No, he's got to go. No, that's a lazy shot by Dax, but... Oh, so he's got it. So that took
5-1.
A like minute and 24 seconds to clear that rack.
This a minute guy and 24 is an seconds. Absolute machine, Gus.
And, well, Sean Partridge has it all to do now, Mikey. Has it all to do.
This guy is an absolute machine, I'll tell you, Gus.
Sean now needs a ball. He's made a ball. He's made a red.
He's potted a red, yep.
Oh, what Gus, do you like here, Mikey?
Gus, he's a chance here to go game. I like yellows.
Well, what about those two yellows?
Yeah, that are clustered
near
there.
The black and that yellow near the red in the centre.
But I have a feeling that bottom yellow goes in the bottom left-hand corner. I have a feeling, just a small feeling. Tell you what, he needs this frame.
Well, he can't go 6. He can't go 6-1 down here. So he's taking yellows. Actually, that high yellow near the black does go in the left center.
Okay.
Well, he's going for the extraction and all that hasn't.
No, he's definitely
turned out like he wanted. I think he's going to take the double on here.
Yeah.
It is. Oh, he loves his double, Sean. I don't think he's missed a double since he's been here. He hasn't missed a double since Nam.
No, he hasn't. When's Nam, Gus?
Alright, so if someone wants to know about Dax, is some of the history or bio on Dax. Dax, he just loves life, really, doesn't he, Dax? He's from Broken Hill in South Australia. New South Wales, sorry, is it?
Yeah, correct.
The Roth, correction by the Roth. And used to live with James Delahunty and Mick Delahunty, I believe.
Yeah.
And, I don't know.
secret pizza eating contests with James Delante.
Used to have secret eating
pizza eating contests.
Pizza eating contest with James Delante.
Yeah.
Really? Well, Dax does love his food, doesn't he? Just by looking at him. Oh, geez, did not know that about Jimmy Della, but because it's, I don't know, where does it go?
Dax Wasley here is definitely a chance of going game here. Nudges into that one, yep. Now, Gus, this is not easy.
Oh, look at that. He's played that like an absolute dream, Dax. Oh, but it's still awkward. If that red goes cleanly. He's looking at it. Do you reckon that red passes clean?
The TV camera can be a little bit deceiving, but I reckon it does just drop in.
You love that one, don't you, Mikey?
Yeah.
The camera can be a little bit deceiving.
Very deceiving, in fact. But I reckon... Oh.
Oh, no, it doesn't. And he's given Sean a chance here. Sean has to take this chance. Now, the yellow does not pass the black to the centre. So, has to take the yellow over the corner.
Bless you, David Rothel.
I think he's just going to pop this yellow and just pop the white out a little bit and settle for a double.
Oh, well, he loves his doubles.
He loves his doubles. Hasn't what quite turned there, out.
You were hoping there. That's not really a show you got to play for. I liked your call. Double in the middle.
Does this double in the left corner?
No. I say no. But then again, I'm wrong.
Yeah. So he has not missed a double since Great Nam. Has not missed one. This is most certainly going to double.
What double you mean, cut the
middle? I think he's actually going to go a double. He does not miss doubles, this guy.
Well, like you said.
Look at it. Oh, no.
He's gotten carried away there, Gus.
And this is 6-1. Well, that's the first double he's missed since Nam.
Dax is just going to eat these.
Oh, but hang on. These are tricky with these pockets, Mikey. Very tricky.
Dax's ability. I don't reckon he's not going to not pot out for me.
Well, it's travelled there a bit.
Drop this in. For the black and the left hand corner.
I just feel like the frame's not over yet.
What do you mean?
Oh, I think it's over now.
Rolls it in.
And there it is, 6-1, Dax Wasley.
You got one more to win, Wasley.
So, it can happen. Sean could come back from here, but, geez, it's all against him, isn't it, Mikey? My co-commentator, just more interested in...
Sorry about that, Gus, I'm back here. I'm back in business. 6-1. Roth has just popped the question, how many balls do you reckon on this break?
Look at those size hands, just quietly.
I say two. One.
Now again, Sean's got another chance here. Pot of the white after break, Dax has.
The black and the yellow there. If you look at the table now, your only problem is that black and yellow.
Correct.
See,
I'll just try and break it straight away.
That's your shot, Gus. You just got to somehow get on this one down the bottom left-hand corner here.
If it was you, Mikey, you would have gone game already.
No. I'd probably missed my first ball already. He's played.
Oh, that's perfect.
Oh, that is a good shot.
I think it'll break out the yellow and black here.
Yep, definitely.
Oh, no, he's running to the red. Oh, it's just become messy all of a sudden.
Tell you what, Shawnee's got a big opportunity here to sort of make the score line a little bit more.
I'm not sure if it's a big opportunity now, Mikey.
No, he's a chance. He could screw into it.
He's going to make something happen here. Look out.
I don't really like it. He's cannon. No.
No, he's run too far there.
I reckon the moment's getting to him, Gussie.
Yeah, look, there was definitely nerves earlier on, and
the nerves earlier on just made the match get away from him.
So Kim's just made a good point. He can put the yellow off the red, screw back, and so the yellow goes in the left centre and break up the black and the yellow.
It's definitely hard.
He's played exactly what Kim has said. Nah, he didn't even get nearer there. So now Daxi's going to look to wrap this up.
Yeah.
But again, that problem is the yellow and the black.
Yeah, it still hasn't moved, does it, Gus? Just run into the yellow. Here we go. He's going to break it up now, I reckon. Do you reckon he will?
Yeah, break I'm not sure what he's... Actually, I'll try and break up now, because look where that yellow is.
Yeah.
The end of the table.
Yeah, exactly. It's safe.
Right, just go a bit of
coverage. Oh, my God. He's just played another safety
shot.
That's
a good shot. He's played two safety shots.
I don't believe my eyes. Dax Wasley has just played two safety shots in this match.
I don't know how he's feeling, but he's played two safeties. I've never seen him play safeties before in my life.
I tell you what. We're seeing everything at these Australian titles.
So now it's the black covering up. Now it's the red covering up the black.
I reckon he can just play a little snooker maybe. No, he's not. The red's on the black too much.
Oh, I'm not sure what he's going for here, but this is dangerous.
Oh, he's going aggressive. That's the Dax we know. Oh, he almost tried to play another safety.
So I think you're fine. Sean's just going to run this yellow down to the bottom right-hand corner. Just cover the hole.
Cover the black ball there. Or is he going to go aggressive and off the black and screw back and
there
just go again?
There is no chance he's going to go aggressive here.
I'll tell you what, Gus, you know him better than me, but from what I've seen...
In this match, he's been holding back. Watching Dax this match, he... Oh, Sean has just had a cracking pot there, Mikey.
And I didn't see it because my brother missed it.
Have a look at that for a pot. Absolute sizzler.
Yeah, so I reckon he's got a bit of a chance here to break out the 8. Or even one rail and land behind the 8 in the bottom left-hand corner.
That's if the black's on, Mikey.
Oh, he's just gone ridiculous.
Nah, and this is... He's in strife here. He's just promoted...
He's just
promoted Dax's
the bottom left
dead ball.
Off the red in the bottom left. Off the red in the bottom left. Oh, he's going safe. Another safety shot from this.
Oh, no, and he's...
Oh, and he's Just killed it again.
So that's just a nothing shot, really.
He's about five shots behind you.
Yeah, he's in the world of hurt now.
Dax
will just play a snooker.
Yeah, he's just playing freaky pool.
Just a shout out to Michael Scary. I'm actually not drunk. So I don't know what you're talking about there, mate.
Just a quick shout out to Jasm, Anthony, and Larry down in Adelaide. Definitely who I practiced with back there.
And I know. Sean's okay. Playing a shocker there. This is over.
Gus, I reckon you could tell me the scoreline, what it's about to be.
It's
going to
be 7-1, mate. And lights out, Sean Partridge.
I bet I could call the out.
He's had a great run. He's, you know, he's.
Sean Partridge. Is this. What's this? His first or second or. How many nationals is Sean?
Nah, it's his first national. First big side.
Last and, 16 of them in singles.
So here we go, Mikey.
Best pool players in the country. Dax Wasley. What a freak show.
This is it.
There it is. Stunned
it there
in
there. It is. 7-1. Dax Wasley.
He's like gobbling
in about 13 minutes.
Dax Wasley, 7-1 through to the last day of the Australian eight ball titles in
that's it.
Perth.
I'll tell you what, he is going to be a threat, ladies and gentlemen.
Ladies and gentlemen, you have just witnessed some Dax magic.
So thank you very much for the for listening in.
Yep.
Signing off now.
Yeah.
Gus and Mikey, got last words, Mikey?
Oh, I'd like to say thank you for listening to us. Hope you enjoyed it. We'll be back tomorrow.
Tomorrow morning. Singles action.
Yeah.
Quarterfinals. That will be huge.
Yeah, nah.
See you later, ladies and gentlemen.
Catch yous later. Love yous lot. Bye.